G'day Jaff Adventures, Terry King here. Welcome to the channel. I'm planning on turning on the monetization feature on my Jaff Adventures YouTube channel. What this means is from this point forward, you'll see ads run during each video and Jaff Adventures will get a cut of the revenue generated from those ads. Now you might be thinking, Terry, you told us you don't and you won't monetize this channel because for you, it's not about the money. Terry, you lied to us, you greasy dog. Want to know why I'm going to monetize the channel and what I'm going to do with the cashola? Stick around. I've been creating content on YouTube now for a little over 2 years, with videos coming out at 3 p.m. Australian Eastern Standard Time every single week. Now, why would I spend literally hours every single week creating content for zero monetary return? To understand that, you've got to understand my why. Why do I choose to create content on YouTube? And listen up, guys, this is important. Number one, it's my belief that everybody would like to contribute in some way or another. It feeds one's feeling of self-belonging and self-worth. And hell, when you get right down to it, it makes you feel good. Whether you contribute or not really relates to the circumstances in your life at that time. Take the flood emergencies that are happening in Brisbane and northern New South Wales right now. Some people have lost everything, no roof over their head, and they don't know where their next meal is coming from. For those individuals, contribution is the furthest thing from their mind right now. They are literally in survival mode. At this exact same time, there are literally thousands of individuals in the Mud Army helping out those flood-affected victims. Those individuals are at a point in their life where they have the opportunity and the means to contribute, and therefore they choose to do so. Jill and I immigrated to Australia in our late 20s with 2 suitcases and $8,000 in our hands, which we promptly blew on a 1979 Sigma, Chrysler Sigma, and a 1982 Hilux. Now, I've worked my ass off for the last 30 years working for the man and later becoming the man so that I could provide for my family. Apart from a few years of volunteering with the Rural Fire Service before we had children, we've not really had the ability to contribute to the broader community. However, like those individuals in the Mud Army right now, I'm at a point in my life where I have the means and the desire to contribute back to the broader community. YouTube is the tool that I've been using for the past 2 years and the tool I'll use going forward to fulfill my need for contribution. Why else would I choose to spend all this time on YouTube creating content for zero money? Reason number two, it keeps me honest. And what I mean by that is, how many projects have you worked on in your life where you've cut corners? You know that this particular way is the A-class way to do it, but you choose to do it the B-class way, either to save a little bit of time or a little bit of money. Now imagine doing a project when you've got 100 people watching you, or maybe 1,000 people watching you. I bet in those circumstances, you would choose every single time to do it the A-class way. And that's how the viewership keeps me honest and improves the outcomes in all of my projects. So thank you for that, guys. Number three, this is my creative outlet. I've got very, very few creative bones in my bodies. I do, however, love photography and videography. And with each video I produce, I learn a little bit more and I try to improve that little bit more. Check out my videos from 2 years ago compared to today. I think they're getting better and I trust you'd agree with that assessment. My friends and family enjoy reliving memories. My trip videos in particular recount great times with great friends. The Jaffa crew get a lot of enjoyment out of watching the videos and that makes me feel good, and that's another reason I do this. Lastly, I guess in some way, this is a bit of a legacy for me. When I'm long gone and covered up, my great-great-grandchildren will get to meet and know their great-great-grandfather. I would have loved the opportunity to meet my great-great-grandfather. Unfortunately, the technology just wasn't there 150 years ago. It does exist now, and I'm going to take advantage of it. So if I've got a great-great-grandchild out here watching that, I hope you guys are enjoying this. This is how life was 150 years ago. So as you can see, there is zero, zip, nada, nothing to do with money and monetary return in the reasons why I choose to create content on YouTube. So if that's the case, why bother monetizing my channel, you ask? And that's a really logical question. Quite simply, I'd like to see more subscribers on the channel. And why would I want that, you ask? Well, think back to the reasons why I'm doing this, around contribution, around keeping me honest, as a creative outlet. In all of these instances, more viewers and more subscribers feeds into my why. The next logical question, of course, is how does monetizing a channel get me more viewers or more subscribers? And I'm not sure about the answer to that, but I've got a hunch that I want to explore. Check this out. Here are the number of views I've had on the channel since I started weekly releases about this time 2 years ago. You look at that and you think, that's pretty good. It's going up and to the left, just like a growing channel should. However, if I zoom into the 1 year scale, you can see that there's zero growth in views over the past 365 days. I have consistently released weekly content during that time and have no growth in the number of views. Either my content is shit and it's not resonating with viewers, or there's something else going on here. Let's take a look at the number of impressions. These are the number of times YouTube suggests one of my videos to a viewer out there. Again, over the lifetime of the channel, it looks like there's pretty strong growth there. However, if I zoom into 365 days, you can see the number of impressions is pretty bloody flat. This really does surprise me because there's twice the number of videos for YouTube to recommend in the last 12 months than there were in the prior 12 months. So again, I have to ask myself, why is that? Lastly, let's have a look at the click-through rate. What this records is the percentage of viewers that have actually clicked on a video that's recommended to them. And those are the videos that appear on the right-hand side of your screen when you're viewing YouTube. As you can see, the click-through rate is pretty bloody consistent over time, apart from the very, very beginning when I started this channel, and I suspect it was just a lot of friends and family that were clicking on the videos, which had a very, very high click-through rate. This tells me that if a Jaffa video is recommended by YouTube, the probability of a viewer clicking on that and watching it is pretty consistent over the life of the channel. Lastly, my subscriber growth rate is consistent but flat at around about 50 subscribers per week. So the number of times YouTube recommends a video is flat over the past year, and the number of views is flat over the past year, despite the increase in the amount of content available to viewers. So what do I conclude from all of this? Either my content is shit and viewers are just not engaged with what I'm creating, but my click-through rate suggests that nothing's changed there, or YouTube is not promoting my content. I suspect YouTube is not promoting the channel content. I think it's related to money, and I've got an experiment that I believe will confirm this hypothesis. Look at it this way. YouTube is a business, and it's a business out there to make money. It makes money by advertisers running ads through the channel. So every time an ad is run, YouTube clips the ticket on the way through. As you know, my channel is not monetized, so every time a Jaffa video is viewed out there, YouTube gets absolutely nothing for it. I know if I owned YouTube, I would preferentially promote those videos that are monetized over those that are not, because by doing that, I actually earn an income. So I'd like to grow my channel to feed my why. I suspect monetization is holding me back. And this is the experiment that I've designed to try and determine whether that's the case or not. If YouTube preferentially promotes monetized channels, I should see a pickup in impressions and in views and in ultimately subscribers on my channel, given my click-through rate is consistent, once I monetize the channel. But right now you're screaming at the channel saying, Terry, you said you aren't doing this for money, and here you go, going back on your word. I retort, I'm definitely not doing this for money, and here's my final proof. I will run this experiment over the next 12 months. Every single cent that I make over that period, I'm going to donate to charity. On top of that, I will match the donation with cash out of my back pocket up to a max of $1,000. And that is a lot of money for me. So what does that look like? If the channel generates $500 over the next 12 months, I'll match that with $500, and there'll be a charity out there that'll receive $1,000. If the channel makes $1,000 over the next 12 months, I'll match that $1,000 with cash out of my back pocket, and I'll donate that $2,000 to a charity. If the channel generates $1,500, I'll put my max $1,000 in, which gives us a total of $2,500, and I'll take that $2,500 and donate it to charity. So you get the idea of what I'm talking about here. If you still think I'm doing this for the money, please leave, because the values that you hold are probably not aligned with what this channel is all about anyway. Bye, Felicia. I'll revisit this topic in 12 months' time and we can review the results of my experiment. If there's an upswing in the metrics I've been tracking, my suspicions will have been validated. If the metrics remain as they are currently, flat, then I'm going to have to do something different because my content isn't resonating with viewers out there and I'm actually just a shit content creator. So I'll be very interested to see how this plays out. Now, what's in store for the channel over the next couple of months? Well, on the 200 series, I've got a few things I'd like to do. Firstly, I'm going to completely replace all the brakes. That's a rotor change and pad change. I'm going to swap out the brake fluid, and I'm going to adjust that awesome Toyota handbrake. So stick around if you want to see that. Secondly, I want to pull the intercooler off this thing and do a complete flush and clean out of the intercooler and record the inlet air temperatures before the clean and after the clean. I'd like to see whether there's an improvement in the efficiency of the intercooler after the clean. And lastly, while still talking about the 200, I bought a new laptop and I lost my version of TechStream. So I've got to get a new version of TechStream on my new laptop so that it can interface with the OBD port and the computers on the 200 series. If you want to see whether I can pull that off or not, that'll be coming up in an upcoming video. Matt Archie and I are planning on doing a Simpson Desert Crossing on the bikes, and I'm doing the prep work to get this thing ready for that Simpson Desert Crossing. So I'll put a video together on exactly what I'm doing to this bike to get it ready for that crossing. And on the FJ45 project, you'll see I've still got my tub here to fit, but I do have the back wall, the windscreen, and the roof fitted temporarily so that I make sure that I get the height of the headboard correct and the body lines correct as well. The reason I need to fit the tub is I need to work out where the stacks will go, the twin stacks, so that I can get the exhaust fitted and get this engine one step closer to hearing the thunder, baby. For those subscribers of the channel, thank you very much. I sincerely appreciate you feeding into my why. Until the next time we meet, everybody, keep the shiny side up. Bye now.